Hi, my name is Evgeny and welcome to my channel. As you might know, developers spend a huge amount of time inside terminals, compiling programs, executing tests, etc. So why shouldn't you make your experience with terminal better? I move from this to this, and I will explain how I did this. Most of you have probably already heard about Bash. In short, Bash is a command language interpreter to interact with your computer through a command line or a terminal. You can watch a cool 100-second video about the Bash on Fireship channel. I will link it in the description. If you are using macOS or Linux, you're probably already using Bash. Though Bash is very popular and can cover most of your use cases, it is old and lacks a better customization and plugin support. Don't get me wrong, Bash is great, but at the same time there is a better choice, and it is ZSH. I wouldn't dive deep into ZSH in this video, because there are so much to say that I can make a whole video about it. But let's just say that ZSH will make your command line experience so much better. I will also be releasing a full article with more details about my command line setup. If you don't want to miss it, click on the link to subscribe to my newsletter, which I will soon start to send out. It will be a monthly newsletter with interesting content about learning to program. First thing first, it is a good idea to install OMyZSH. It is an open source community driven framework on top of the ZSH that helps you to manage configuration. To install it, you need to copy this link and pass it into your terminal. It shouldn't take too long to install. After installation, you will instantly see that your terminal changed the way it looks. It is because OMyZSH has a default theme that it applies after installation. If you are interested, you can choose your own theme. There is a wide collection of them on their GitHub page. The link will be in the description as well. Some themes make your terminal look cleaner and some add more information for you to see. So it is up to you which one fits you better. You can easily get away with just using the default terminal application on your machine, but it will be limited in functionality comparing to alternatives. I for myself chose the iTerm2. It supports multiple panes and you don't need to keep switching between tabs or trying to align multiple terminal windows. The customization options of iTerm2 is beyond the default macOS terminal, and things like key binding, easy search and support of various plugins convince me to use it over the terminal. If you prefer the default terminal, you still can use it, and you will still have the same look and feel as my setup. There is another alternative that I haven't tried yet, but it is gaining a lot of attention recently. It is called Hyper. Don't know much about it, I just know that it supports most of the platforms, it is built on Electron, which makes it pretty customizable, and it also supports plugins. One of them is called Hyper Power, that adds a cool wow effect to your terminal when you type. To install iTerm or Hyper, I will include the links in the description. The most awesome and useful tool out of all that I mentioned is fig.io. I recently started using it as a replacement for my autocomplete plugin, and then I fell in love with it. The sheer amount of features that it provides you is insane. It is very easy to install, it supports Bash, ZSH and Fish. It integrates easily with any terminals, IDEs and platforms. It gives you the ability to use this pretty autocomplete where you can see all of the available options for your next command. Choose the one you want and even read the description. I think it is a very powerful tool for beginners because it will show you what other commands or flags are there without reading a documentation. Fig supports ZSH plugins and it is much easier to install them through Fig than actually editing some random file in the random place on your computer. You just type Fig in your terminal and it will open dashboard. There you can go to plugins and see all the plugins separated by category with how many stars they have on GitHub. Then by clicking install, Fig will do all the bells and whistles for you. If you want, try installing plugins or themes on OMyZSH without Fig, and you will see all the benefits yourself. Some of the cool plugins that I have on the screen, I suggest you to read about them and try it out. Fig also provides you with the ability to edit your .dot files, means all your aliases, secrets, etc. It used to be for more advanced usage, but because it is so easy, you can do it very quickly yourself. For example, if you have a command that you type all the time, you can make a short alias to replace it. Again, just type fig, go to .dot files, and then you will see aliases. Just click new block, aliases, or scroll down and click add under the aliases. Then you can type any command on the right and replace it with the short version on the left. When you're done, just close the dashboard and type fig source in your terminal. And you're done. Your new aliases is added. Here are some cool aliases I have. For example, if I'm inside some project with a GitHub repository, I just type gop and it opens a GitHub page of that repository. It uses git open plugin that I also installed through fig. Another one is when I type London, it shows me a weather in London, and there is a short version LNDN, which shows a short version of weather in London. There are a lot of different plugins that I use and make my life easier. If you want me to make a video describing all of my plugins, smash the like button and subscribe to my channel. Fig has much more features to cover that I don't think I have time to cover, such as workflow, SSH credentials. Also, it syncs everything between computers, so if you have a work computer and a personal computer, they both will have the same setup, which I think is awesome. You don't need to do the same thing twice. I will include all the links for Fig in the description. So that's it. That was a brief intro to my terminal setup. Let me know if you like it or have any suggestions to improve it. I'm always keen to learn about new tools or features that I'm not aware of. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hit that like button for the algorithm and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next one. Bye.